saw aerodynamic braking from the stall guys as they cross controlled. They use the entire fuselage because those are very teeny wheels, and if they tried to stop quickly, the brakes would be toast.
Oh, absolutely. And these aircraft come in at a fairly high rate of speed as part of the landing process. And on final approach, they cross over the even runway there, typically around 170, 180 miles an hour, which is faster than any airplane I fly. It's quite nervous and such.
Me too.
But it's an aircraft that, we talk about, it's named of the fighting falcon. That was the original name given by General Dynamics and later Lockheed Martin. But if you meet with any pilot out there or any of the mechanics or those who are around the aircraft, they affectionately call it the Viking. And I think that's actually a reference to a Battlestar Galactica thing back in the day. It kind of had a similar view, and it's got a cool mean appearance to it. So the Viper is what is best known in the surface.
And it's easier to say Viper driver than Fighting Falcon driver.
Yeah. This sounds cooler. That's important.
From the Stingers at the one. Did you say 180? 180th. Yes, fighter squadron at the Toledo Air National Guard. Now, I started to introduce Stephanie Strickland before we saw the F-16s coming in. Steph, you have been the social media guru for so many air shows around the country. You have your finger on the pulse of stuff.
The Viper demonstration pilot. Was a gentleman whose call sign was Toro. Toro actually took a Battlestar Galactica actress, her name is Trisha Helfer, for a backseat ride. If you are familiar with the remake of the series, she was the Cylon in the red dress, if you will, and she crushed it. So she pulled 9.6G that day, became a member of the 9G club, did not get sick, did not pass out.
Wow.
And he was so excited because he watched that show.